Can you guess what's wrong with this code? At first glance, everything seems to be correct. We want to cache some data so that it's faster to reaccess it later, and for this, we're using a dictionary. And indeed, when you think about it, a dictionary seems like the perfect data structure to implement a cache. There's just one issue. There's absolutely nothing in our code that prevents the dictionary from infinitely increasing in size as we keep adding more entries to it. With a simple data structure, this might not be such a big issue. But let's imagine that we're storing a larger sort of data, like images. Now it's easy to see how an infinitely growing cache of images could become an issue quite fast. Fortunately, Foundation comes with a built-in type that implements a cache which will take care of automatically removing entries as memory starts to become tight. This type is called NSCache, and as we'll see, it's relatively straightforward to use. NSCache basically offers the same API than a dictionary, with one big difference: it can only handle reference types, not value types. So for the key of the cache, we can solve the problem by casting it to an NS string, which is a reference type equivalent of string. But for the value, we'll need to create a simple class that allows us to store a value type inside a reference type. And that's it. Now we can rewrite our previous code to use an NS cache instead of a dictionary. As you can see, the code looks very similar. The only difference is that NS cache is a bit more verbose to use. That's all for this video. I hope that you've enjoyed discovering NS cache. If you ever need to implement caching inside your iOS app, I really recommend that you use this type and that you spend time reading its documentation to learn about all the possibilities to customize its behavior. As usual, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss my next video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.